to the Dominiques.
Ball goes down into the post. A lot of pushing and shoving down there.
Not giving Sienna Pollard any room, and that's definitely the way you got to defend her.
We get a second look at this play on the low block.
And you see the help defense coming over from LeClerc. She does commit the foul, but they're not going to give Pollard any space, and that's definitely got to be the game plan.
Penetration off window, no good. Rebounded by Adams. High arcing three ball, won't catch anything but air. Pollard's going to hit that one out of bounds on the attempted offensive rebound. St. Foy is going to take over on the baseline.
Mariners looking a little cold from the three-point line, but we know they're going to heat up. It's just a matter of when.
St. Foy finally able to get that ball past the timeline. Fighting through this tenacious defense from the Mariners. Seven to shoot. Another second chance opportunity put up, but Adams is going to come down with the board.
And that's another offensive rebound given up by the Mariners. And here is Pollard with the back down off the left hand. It won't drop.
Three ball from up top. It's going to rattle around. The shooter's roll will fall.
And that is number 13, Kim Letang, with the triple.
Adams with it on the wing, dribble handoff. St. Foy doing a good job of closing down the passing lanes here. Late shot clock shot. Won't go for Adams.
But that's where they got to get find her shots from, Ryan. Right around the top of the key. And she comes up with the steal, the active hands of Lene Adams.
Adams now trying to set the offense. Toss it up top. 4-3. Won't go for Clark. Mariners really struggling to find their stroke here in the early going.
Lainey Adams.
A rebound for Adams.
From the guard position, Ryan, she is definitely a terror on the glass.
Adams with it now up top. Gets it back. Only five to shoot. Corner three. Won't go. Pollard tries to swat it to a teammate in the corner, but nobody's there. That ball's going to go out of bounds, and St. Foy will take over.
Ryan, I'd really like to see the Mariners play inside out. You know, yesterday they established some play from the inside, going down low to Pollard and working off that block, and then shooting the long ball, you know, once they've established a presence inside.
St. Foy looking to break this tie.
Pollard came over with some help defense there.
Shot off the window too strong. Pass goes inside to Pollard. Great footwork from Pollard. She's going to get the two-pointer to go off window and in.
It's exactly what I was just talking about, going down low and finding some easy money.
Mariners defense coming up big there with the stop. Ball batted out of bounds on the baseline. St. Foy is going to keep it. So we take a second look at this ball. Last touched by a Mariners player. Three to shoot. Needs to get the shot off. She will. It'll spin all the way around the rim, but it's going to pop out. Two players are going to grab the rebound at the same time, so jump ball will be the call.
And it was Lene Adams once again doing work on the glass.
Versatile player Adams is running the point, also grabbing her fair share of rebounds.
Pollard working from the high post.
And the three ball, it's gonna fall. Jamie McFarland.
The Mariners going inside out consecutively on two offensive plays, and they come up with 5 points because of it.
St. Juan needs to respond. Dominique tossed that one up. Seemingly up there forever, but that two-pointer is gonna go.
And a nice strong take to the rack.
Mariners up 12-9. And the foul, official's gonna go up with the right hand. Foul's gonna be called to Abigail LaBerge. So we get another look at this three-pointer by the Mariners. Ball's gonna go inside out. The high arcing shot falls for McFarland. Extends this Mariners lead. Now up three. Adams with it up top. 7 on the shot clock. Adam gives the screen, wanted the ball back. It's tipped out of bounds, and when the Mariners inbound this one, they're gonna have 3 to shoot. Gonna need to get a shot off rather quickly if they wanna avoid the shot clock violation. Shot will be good if it goes, but it's gonna catch nothing but air.
Defended well there by the Diamondbacks, forcing Pollard to shoot the long triple. Definitely not out of range, but just 3 seconds on that shot clock, definitely a difficult scenario.
Dominique with an opportunity to tie it here. Two ball, won't go, another rebound for Adams. Adams not letting her size distinguish what she's able to do on the glass. A couple rebounds in the early going as Pollard takes it inside. The step through won't fall.
And she is slow getting back.
That's going to be a 3. Now, come up short, however.
We see number 15, Caitlin Brown, in the game for the Mariners. Another good post player for VIU.
VIU perhaps looking to establish a presence on the low block. A defensive battle here early on with 22 seconds left to play in this first quarter. VIU up 3 points. A low scoring affair to start, especially with two teams such offensive prowess.
Brown too strong on that one. 5 seconds left.
The kiss off the glass will fall. Leia Dominique gonna get that shot to go, and it's gonna close out the first quarter. Mariners up 12-11 over the Dominiques. I'm Ryan Blevins, he's Kobe K. More CCAA Women's Basketball National Championship action coming up after this quick commercial break.
Manpower, that's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the $1 billion parkway. That's real manpower in action. End to end, over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LIUNA, Feel the power.
It's new, it's fresh, it's innovative. It's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, places, and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WeTV, we got you covered.
I'm Ryan Blevins alongside my broadcast partner, Colby Kay. And Colby, what was the difference in that first quarter in this low-scoring affair?
Well, we had very strong play from number 7, Lene Adams, for the VIU Mariners. 2-for-3 from the field, 1-for-1 from the three-point line. We talked about her ability to rebound the basketball. 6 total boards and an assist, so she is definitely the best player in this game so far. For VIU, they've got to get Sarah Simovic going. She was 0-for-2. VIU went 5-for-14 from the field, struggling a little bit. You talked about some of that defense. And for the Dominiques, 4-of-18 from the field. But they did have 15 total rebounds to VIU's 8, so they're definitely going to have to do a better job on the glass. Like you said, Ryan, this is definitely a defensive game through the first quarter.
VIU has led from the first basket, getting out-rebounded, but still hold a one-point lead as this second quarter gets underway, as Brown with the turnaround shot won't go. St. Foy looking to get something going on offense. Have an opportunity to take the lead here. Gets the screen. Dishes it across the court. Good penetration. Offensive rebound. Looks like VIU is going to come up with it. Pollard, little contact. No call. Her shot won't fall.
She has the ability to go coast to coast, Ryan. She just couldn't finish.
For the athletic players, we see a three ball fired up. It's going to go off the side of the rim and out. And we have a timeout called on the floor by Coach LaRocque.
And really, Ryan, both teams struggling mightily from the field. And I think right now, it's about continuing to play defense, but really finding yourself offensively, trying to get good looks. VIU brought Caitlin Brown into the game and tried to go down low to her. She hasn't finished a few times off the block, but they've got to stick with that plan, in my opinion. And for the Dominiques, they've had a great deal of success penetrating the lane. They've been able to get inside, but they're not finishing at the rim either. They've blown a few layups. So really, it's going to be about efficiency and who can find themselves offensively.
The Dominiques 1-for-4 from 3 in that first quarter. Mariners not shooting much better. 2-for-5. Neither team really getting it going from deep. Definitely going to need to try and get the ball inside to some of their bigger players.
The Dominiques also had 5 turnovers. The VIU Mariners had 3. So protecting the basketball, imperative in games like this. In a tournament situation, you know, playing for that medal.
You're watching CCAA Women's Basketball National Championship action on we-tv.ca. Live from the St. Clair College Sportsplex.
Third and final day of the tournament. Gotta wonder, is fatigue a factor at this point? We will find out.
Pollard with it, baseline, dishes across the floor. 3 to shoot. Pollard's gonna need to do something here. Good if it goes, it won't.
Dominiques playing some great zone defense there, forcing the Mariners right into the end of the shot clock.
Shot clock winding down here for the Dominiques as well. They're going to fire up a corner 3. It's going to go. Miriam LeClerc for downtown. And the shot that one from the Detroit River.
And the Diamondbacks take their first lead of the game up over the Mariners, 14-12. Emily Clark off on the three ball there.
Off window, it'll go. Timeout's gonna be called by the Mariners as we see Lori Marchand doing a little window shopping. We're gonna get a second look. Going all the way coast to coast are the Diamondbacks. Good penetration by Marchand. She's gonna kiss it off the glass and it'll fall.
And the Diamondbacks coach has gotta be happy with the way his team played following the last timeout. We talked about their ability to penetrate that line and then being able to finish at the rim, and that's exactly what happened. So he was praising his team as they were on the way to the huddle.
A great effort from both teams. Diamondbacks able to claw their way back into this one.
Fans out in the stands looking like they're having a good time here at the lovely St. Clair College Sportsplex on this fine Saturday afternoon.
This timeout's going to wind down here.
What a great opportunity it has been having this tournament, Ryan, in Windsor for 2016. Great way to bring the community together and show off this facility here at St. Clair, who's shown a real commitment to athletes all over not only the province, but the country.
The new facility we have here at St. Clair, showcased throughout the weekend. There is basketball to be played, however, as we see VIU try and get the ball inside. That's gonna go out of bounds. Poehler tried to save it. Couldn't get anything going on the dribble drive.
Some great defensive communication going on by the Diamondbacks, who are bringing over help defense every time Poehler goes down low.
Diamondbacks trying to kick it back outside, turn the ball over. Adams with it on the wing now. Gives back to Simovic. Simovic tries for the scoop and score, but she can't get that one to go. Got a foul called.
And here's Simovic penetrating in. Now, although that doesn't drop, this is an opportunity now, Ryan, for her to get to the line and start with some offense. She cracked 20 points yesterday. She's just a fantastic player as she misses the first.
Broadcaster's curse there. She'll miss the first of two here at the charity stripe.
But they do got to get her going. Number three can score in bunches.
She'll hit her second, one for two during that trip to the line for Simovic. Ball tapped out of bounds on the baseline. Gonna stick with the Diamondbacks.
They currently hold a 16-13 lead over the VIU Mariners. The Diamondbacks playing some great defense thus far.
Corner three. Try to get a shooter's bounce there, but it won't go. Ball's on the deck. Great effort by both teams there. And get a second chance to look at this off the missed shot. Great effort by both squads, not afraid to hit the floor. Fight for that possession, both teams knowing every possession is important here in tournament play.
That's twice now Lene Adams has gone after that basketball. Great ball instincts, causing the jump ball and subsequently earning her team two possessions. So it's really about that effort on the defensive end that's caused Lenny Adams to allow her team to come up with the basketball.
Mariners have it on the wing now. Get it inside to Pollard. She's going to get the turnaround shot. It's going to be blocked, denied by Siros.
Number 24 with the swat on Sienna Pollard.
We're going to have a moving screen called.
Number 10, Dominique Dore, a little too aggressive there, trying to set up the screen for her teammate, and that subsequently caused a turnover. Mariners ball.
Mariners trying to set offense here late in the shot clock. Adams can't go off window. Pollard's going to be fouled. Her shot won't go, so she's going to go to the line for two. Fouls on number 12, Maggie Chabot. So we get a second look at Adams' effort.
We've watched in this tournament, Ryan, Adams take that shot right from around the elbow. There she elected to take a dribble to try to get closer to the basket, but she's really, you know, found that sweet spot from those elbow positions. But fortunately, Sienna Pollard able to get on the line and find some offense. 16-14 now, the Dominiques lead the Value Mariners.
The IU going to need a stop if they want to get back into this one. Only down two. Pass goes all the way across the court. Good penetration by St. Foix. They're going to get the shot off. It'll fall for two off the window.
Abigail LaBerge finding some success on the inside. Points in the paint mounting for the Dominiques.
Another three fired up by VIU. Foul out there on number six, Jamie McFarland.
McFarland being a little too aggressive there, going for the basketball.
McFarland gonna try and nab this steal here. A little too much contact, however, and she knows. St. Foix leads. A back and forth game as Pollard tipped that one away, but right into the hands of St. Foix. Five to shoot now. Need to get a shot off. Late in the shot clock. Basket won't count. Ball's going to be turned over. VIU is going to take over on the sideline.
The Mariners bench celebrating and praising their players for a great defensive effort.
VIU looking to capitalize on the mistake. Pollard can't get her shot to go. She looks rather frustrated, really struggling to get anything going offensively inside. Five to shoot now. Another great defensive effort. Three ball from the wing.
LaBerge takes the extra dribble and earns herself a good shot, but it does not fall.
Offensive rebound by St. Foix. Foul underneath, shot won't go. And here you see the last play. Foul called underneath on the dribble drive. Right idea there for Lori Marchand, but just couldn't fight through the traffic there. We'll see a timeout taken by the Mariners.
That is three fouls now for Sienna Pollard, as she may have to take a seat. And, you know, if they lose her in the paint, that is it's going to be a big blow to this team, Ryan. She has been defended very, very well by the Diamondbacks throughout the course of this game, really shutting her down in the paint. She has got off some good shots from the block, but nothing falling, and you can definitely see a little frustration there.
Pollard with only 2 points in that first quarter. Obviously frustrated. She's not able to get anything going. The pristine scorer that she is.
Simovic also needing to find herself offensively with 1 point, and then Renee Adams with the really hot start. She had 5 points in the first quarter, but has not scored here in the second. So the Mariners may need to look to their bench to find some relief offensively. For the Diamondbacks, they got to just continue taking it to the hole. They're finding a great deal of success there.
In the arena now, the Ooks, winners of the last game, will take on the winner of this game, either the VIU Mariners or the St. Foy Dominiques, doing a little bit of scouting here. As we see the first free throw attempt from Marchand will not go. Nor will the second, so Pollard will stay in the game despite being in some foul trouble. She's going to come down with the defensive rebound. Adams' shot's going to go in and out. Nothing really falling for either team in this low-scoring game. 3:10 left to play in the first half. Baseline drive is going to hit the bottom of the backboard. It's going to result in a St. Foy ball out of bounds. Gets the ball inside, had a good look. Now going to find the low post player. Second chance opportunity won't go for Triquette. Ball saved by the Mariners. Adams gives the screen, only 6 to shoot. She'll fire up a 3. Shot that one from the Ambassador Bridge, and it's going to go.
Lene Adams gets back on the board. 8 points now in this one. The Mariners desperately needed that triple.
Long range shot starting to fall for Adams and VIU.
What a take.
Off window to extend this lead. 20-17, St. Foy is up.
Marchand finishes with the left hand. Calling for Lene Adams.
Adams drive. Can't get the hook shot to go. Awkward looking shot. Needs to get back and play some defense. Adams perhaps looking a little fatigued. Too strong, but the second chance opportunity is gonna fall.
Another offensive rebound and another 2 points in the paint for the Diamondbacks.
Dominique Doré with the second chance opportunity as Pollard has another shot blocked, but she was fouled on the way up. She's gonna go to the line with a chance to shoot two.
Free throws, so important, Ryan, in a game like this when you're playing from behind, every single point counts. Pollard with 3 points so far in this one.
Leia Dominique and Nada Kalefi checking in for the Diamondbacks.
And I wanted to make a quick correction. I apologize. Pollard with 2 fouls. Not 3. I stand corrected. But she did make her first free throw. 4 points. Make it 5.
Brown checks back into the game for VIU.
And that's the... a good thing to have her on your roster. Speaking of Victoria Brown, when Pollard needs to sit down, they have another big to come in and man the position from down low.
Nearly stolen away by the Mariners. Instead, it's going to result in 2 points for St. Croix. The easy lay-in for Kim Letang.
And another 2 points in the paint. They are having a great deal of success down low.
Letang's going to tip it out of bounds. Emily Clark to inbound here. Finds Adams, now back to Clark. Clark crosses up top, dishes to the wing. Six to shoot, gets a screen from Brown. Fires up the long ball. It's gonna go. 24-22, St. Foy leads.
Simovich, that is exactly who the Mariners needed to step up and score. Good news if you're a Mariners fan.
The turnaround's gonna fall for Leclerc. Leclerc really imposing her will down low.
Seconds left in the second quarter. Lene Adams setting up shop at the top of the perimeter.
Only a few milliseconds separating shot and game clock, but Brown's gonna get it to go off window.
This pick and roll working for the Mariners there.
Shot wouldn't have counted if it went. And at the end of the first half, the Dominiques are on top, 26-24 over the Mariners. I'm Ryan Blevins, he's Colby Kay. We're gonna take a quick commercial break, but stick with us. More CCAA Women's Basketball National Championship action. Second half coming up after this.
Manpower. That's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the $1 billion parkway. That's real manpower in action. End to end, over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LIUNA. Feel the power.
It's new, it's fresh, it's innovative, it's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, places, and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WeTV, we got you covered.
Welcome back to the St. Clair College Sportsplex, the site of the 2016 CCAA Women's National Basketball Championships. Halftime of this bronze medal semifinal game between the Vancouver Island University Mariners and the Dynamique de Sainte-Foy. The Sainte-Foy team winning 26-24. After 20 minutes of play, as he's done all week with us, assistant coach Jonas Pierre joins us. Coach Pierre, thanks for doing this again. And I guess the good thing is you come away with a halftime lead, which is nice.
Yeah, it's always nice to be leading, especially about with a tough game we had last night. Not a lot of time to rest and recuperate from last night.
Yeah, you lead me right to my next question, Coach Pierre. The emotional part of it, losing last night, and having to come back prepared today, how did you prepare the girls? What was the talk like in the dressing room?
We just told them to forget about yesterday, and it's basketball. You just got to move on and on to the next game.
Coach Dave LaRoche, very intense man. Energy is a key element to this. We saw a game earlier that was filled with energy. What did you think of the energy level of your team in the first half here?
We started off slow, but I think we finished strong. And we picked up the energy, and I think the energy, if it keeps going on, it's going to be, we're going to do a lot more things, and we're going to play way better second half if we keep the energy, if we keep building on that energy.
You talked about the turnaround time to come back and play another game here, Coach. And for you and Coach LaRoche, not only do you have to turn it around, come back and play an early game here, but you have to examine that next team you're playing, a team you don't play regularly. How tough was that to do to prepare for this team?
Well, we all week since we've been here since Thursday, we watched everybody play. So we kind of know, we take notes on everybody because you never know what's going to happen. You always hope for the best, but you still got to have plan B, plan C. So we looked at everybody. We kind of had a feel on everybody.
How's the, I want to say, how's the, not the energy, but how much do you think the girls have left in them? Can they pull this out and can they play another bronze, get into a bronze medal game?
Yeah, that's what it comes to, practice, you know what I'm saying, going hard in practice. It's for situations like this. You have to keep going. You, when they tell you to run suicide lines and everything, that's what you have. That's when it comes in place. Yeah.
They don't like the coaches at that time, but they probably thank them after this. What's Coach LaRoche saying right now?
We got to keep fighting. That's it, keep fighting.
Jonas Pierre, we appreciate your time. Hopefully we'll get to talk to you again after a bronze medal game. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.
Jonas Pierre, the assistant coach of the Dynamiques de Sainte-Foy. Quick timeout. When we come back, we'll check in with the Vancouver Island University team. Franjo Cirkovic, the fine assistant coach, will be on hand with us. You're watching the CCAA Women's Basketball Championships on WEE TV.
Manpower. That's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the billion-dollar parkway. That's real manpower in action. End-to-end over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well-trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LIUNA. Feel the power.
It's new, it's fresh, it's innovative, it's WEE TV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.wee-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WEE TV has what you're looking for. The people, places, and faces of our community are front and center on WEE TV. Check out www.wee-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WEE TV, we got you covered.
Welcome back to the LIUNA 6-5 halftime report. We're at the Women's CCAA National Basketball Championships here at the St. Clair College Sportsplex. The VIU Mariners taking on the Sainte-Foy team, the bronze medal semifinal game. Sainte-Foy up 26-24 at halftime. Franjo Cirkovic, the assistant coach of VIU, joins us. Give me your thoughts, Coach, about that first half, what you thought of it.
Good game, back and forth. You know, these are the type of games at the end of the year that we need to start doing the easy stuff the best, and those basic fundamentals of being an athlete are going to really kind of be depending on the outcome, the deciding factor of the game, yeah.
Are you surprised at all the energy level? I mean, let's face it, this has been a tough 2 days just to get to this point. And I know they're all great athletes, but the physicality of this tournament has been really at a high level.
Yeah, our girls are really resilient girls. We shake our head a lot. You know, this when we think they're a little bit down, they double or triple the energy that they find somehow. And our girls, knock on wood, are normally a second half team, so we'll see what's going on here. But they'll find, if they want it, they'll find it.
Preparation for this game, it's a quick turnaround, Coach. And I know you've been watching in the stands. I'm sure you have your notes, but it's still got to be a little bit of a challenge for you and Coach Bill McWinney to maybe tweak and fine-tune those things here.
Yeah, it is. You know, when you at the end of the year here and you're watching these teams and small amount of time to prepare for them, but our, again, like I said yesterday, our mentality has been making sure our team's prepared and fixing the mistakes and making the good things even better just for our team. And ultimately, it depends. We're the factor. If VIU is going to show up, then we'll be okay. If VIU isn't going to show up, then there might be some issues.
What did you think your team did well in that first half, Coach? And what do they need to maybe bring up to another level to find a way to win this game?
I thought they started to be a little bit more active on the offensive end, looking to score and wanting to score. I think we need to be a little bit more physical down there. We need to own the boards defensively. We're not boxing out very well right now. And we need to play with nothing to lose, you know. We got to go out there and do all those basic things as best as we can, and the outcome should be good. But we just got to play with some heart, and we have the heart. We just got to turn it up a little bit more.
When you get to this point in the season, I mean, you're in your last couple of games of the year, Coach. Yeah. Do you maybe try something different, or is there something you can try to do differently to Or do you just go with what's been working all year?
Go with what's been working and hope the girls find that energy and that resiliency, and that's all we can hope for, really. There's not much time to really try anything different. We can't change our daily routines, our game day routines. You know, it's just what we've been doing all year, and that's why we've been doing it all year.
That's why you're here. You've had a great year, that's for sure. I'll let you get back in the room, Coach. Good luck the rest of the way, and hopefully a bronze medal game in the near future for you and your squad.
I want to say hi to my daughter, Livia. Tata loves you, and we'll see you soon.
Well said. What a guy, that's for sure. Coach Franjo Cirkovic doing it all here, that's for sure. And his team down a couple of points right now, 26-24. A quick timeout. We'll check in with our broadcast team, Ryan Blevins and Mitch Kobe-Kay. They'll have some of the half numbers for you. And we'll also come back and preview what's still to come here on WE TV. You're watching the 2016 CCAA Women's National Basketball Championships on WE TV.
Hello, I'm Ryan Blevins alongside my broadcast partner, Kobe-Kay. You just saw the first half of the CCAA bronze medal semifinal game. Dominiques on top of the Mariners by a score of 26-24. Kobe, rebounding, the big difference in the first half.
It definitely was, and it contributed to the Dominiques taking over the lead and then getting out of here with a slight edge here, 2-point advantage. They had 28 total rebounds to the Mariners 14, so doubling them up on the glass, definitely something that needs to be addressed at the halftime. We'll take a look at some of the other numbers. The Dominiques shooting 4-for-18 through the first half, 4-for-9 from the three-point line, so they really found themselves from range, 4-6 from the line. So those are decent numbers. They want to sharpen things up a little bit from the field, and they only had 4 turnovers, and I thought they were very careful with the basketball in the second quarter. Pardon me, that was the Mariners. 14 total rebounds, 4 turnovers, definitely better than the second quarter. Lene Adams had 8 points. She got things going a little bit in the second quarter with the 3-point basket. She had 5 in the first quarter. Sienna Pollard with 5 total points. She ended up getting to the free throw a few times, but then it was Sarah Simovic. We seen her come on late with that 3 ball. She had 4 total points. And then for the other side, the Dominiques, 9 of 25 from the field, 2 of 8 from downtown. So not finding all that much success from the three-point line, but they were definitely really strong in the paint. They had 8 total team assists, rotated the ball very, very well. They had 7 turnovers collectively, and they did have 6 points off their bench. So the second unit providing some relief, and it was Miriam Leclerc with 9 points, Kim LePeng with 5 points. Those are your lead scorers for your Dominiques.
The Mariners definitely able to get back into this game with the use of the 3 ball. Those are your halftime stats. And for more, I'm going to kick it to the sideline for the third member of our broadcast team, Dominic Papa.
We continue on with the Leona 6-5 halftime report to 26-24. St. Foy leading Vancouver Island University in this game. Again, the winner going to the bronze medal game. That'll be at 6 p.m. We do know the opponent there will be the Nate Ooks. Speaking of other games, we'll be back here right shortly after 2 p.m. and then around there. The 7th and 8th place game will take place. That'll feature the St. Mary's Lightning taking on the host team, the St. Clair College Saints. Both those teams will be looking to finish the year on a winning note. The 6 p.m. slot will be the Browns bronze medal game. And then at 8:15 in and around there, we'll be back with our coverage of the CCAA Women's Gold Medal Championship game. The Humber Hawks, the number 2 seed from Ontario, will take on the Holland Hurricanes, the number 4 seed. It's shaping up to be an outstanding game. We'll have all the action for you here on WE TV. Third quarter action is just about set to go here. We're going to take a quick timeout when we do come back. Ryan Blevins and Mitch Kobe-Kay will have the call for you. You're watching the 2016 CCAA Women's National Basketball Championships on WE TV.
Manpower, that's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the $1 billion parkway. That's real manpower in action. end to end over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well-trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LiUNA, feel the power.
It's new, it's fresh, it's innovative, it's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, places, and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WeTV, we got you covered.
I'm Ryan Blevins alongside my broadcast partner, Colby Kay. Second half of the CCAA Women's Basketball National Championship bronze medal semifinal game coming up. The first half saw the Dominiques take a 2-point lead over the Mariners. Winner of this one's going to get the Ooks. Alberta Institute of Technology Ooks win the first contest, play the winner of this game. The Ooks are in the gym doing a little bit of scouting. Colby, we took us over some halftime stats during the break. Definitely going to need to see the Mariners' big three come out of this one, perhaps get their inside post game going.
They also need to defend the paint better, Ryan. They gave up a whole bunch of points inside. The Dominiques able to penetrate, get in there, and do some real damage. And that is an area that most definitely needs to be addressed along with the rebounds. So we'll have to see what these two teams have come up with, you know, through their huddle in these halftime and how they come out and answer the bell.
The CCAA championships have been on here all week and here today on we-tv.ca. Highlighting the beautiful facility we have here at the St. Clair Sportsplex. As we have a foul on the floor early, called on Jamie McFarland. She hits the deck rather hard. Called for the foul nonetheless. St. Foy swinging the ball all around. Good penetration, they'll kick to the corner. Goes left hand, won't go.
Simovic able to slow things down to set up, shop.
Simovic tries to dish down low to Sienna Pollard. Pollard had that one batted out of bounds, couldn't handle the pass. St. Foy's gonna take over. And another turnover here. We see Emily Clark just nab that one out of the air, intercepted. Three ball fired up from the wing, no good for Simovic.
The Mariners now 4-for-10 from downtown. They found some range there in the second quarter though from the 3-point line.
Good baseline pass. That ball's gonna float right over the rim, however. Three ball from the wing won't go. The offensive rebound and the easy make for Leah Dominique.
Absolutely, nobody defending number 7 for the Dominiques. She's able to score for another 2 points in the paint.
Dominiques, the easy 2 points looking to defend. As Pollard can't get that one to go, really struggling from inside as Pollard. That three ball is gonna spin out, won't fall. Simovic with it now on the fast break. Adams is gonna keep this one alive. Looks to get the screen. Good roll from Pollard. Goes over her right shoulder. We're going to have a foul call. Maggie Chabot called for that one. So we get a second look at this foul called to Chabot. Good pick and roll action from Pollard. Couldn't get the shot to go. Hasn't seen many fall for her tonight.
Simovic forcing the issue there on the baseline.
.28-24 is the score here in the third quarter. Can't get it to go off the glass. Gonna take it the other way, will VIU. Floater in the lane's gonna fall for Adams.
That is the area in the paint where she has had success all throughout this tournament scoring.
Adams showing her versatility, having a ton of rebounds in the first half. Getting the floater to go, bring her team within 2 points. A one possession game, and she's gonna come up with the steal. Active hands and good defense. We have a foul called here to Rachel Marco.
And I think right now, Ryan, with the way that the Mariners are playing, you know, really trying to find themselves, it is Lene Adams who's been the strongest player in this game for both teams. And I think they really need to go to her and let her do her thing. I think she's having a great afternoon. And she might be able to provide the leadership, you know, for this team to get out of here with a W.
Dominic Doré checking in now for St. Foix. Adams dominating in every facet of the game, still has her team down two. Has an opportunity to tie and take the lead here. They'll take the tie. Lene. Jumper good for Emily Clark.
And Lene Adams uses her body to create space for the jump shot for Emily Clark.
VIU running their tenacious full court press. And that one will fall off window. Good for 2 points, 30-28.
Beautiful pass inside off the give and go. Another 2 points in the paint for the Diamond Eakes.
Kim Letang credited with that one. Four to shoot now. That one will go. Pollard tries to save it. She'll just toss that one into the baseline.
Diamond Eakes holding fast here. They are up by 2 points, 30-28. Playing great team basketball. We're seeing good ball facilitation, good defense, and obviously good work in the paint.
VIU trying to run the trap. Won't work as Sirois gets it out. Looks like that foul is gonna be called to McFarland. Already getting into some foul trouble is McFarland. Had a couple called on her tonight.
Yeah, she has three, Ryan, so definitely has to be careful. She is an important player, and that's number six on the guard position for the Mariners.
Ball brought back the other way by Adams. She's gonna elect to slow it down here. Simovic on the wing, gets the screen from Adams. Down low to Pollard. She's gonna be fouled.
I've noticed this Diamond Eagles team playing really physical all afternoon, and it's really worked for them, especially in the painted area. They're not giving up any space. They're really fighting. They're not giving Pollard any room to do her thing. McFarland with a much needed bucket to tie things up, 30 up.
30 all here. 4 minutes and 30 seconds left to go in this third quarter. Coach Dave LaRocque's team trying to regain their lead. Offensive rebound, Three ball. That one's going to go. Lori Marchand from downtown.
Second chance points opportunities killing the Mariners.
That three ball will fall just short off the front iron.
Great box out by Kate Serville.
Ball comes to the wing now. St. Foy up three. Pollard able to get the steal, and she's going to be called for the foul. Some displeasure there from Pollard.
That will now be her third foul, Ryan. She was very aggressive there in that push-off trying to get that basketball and gets called for it.
Pollard extending that arm, shoving the St. Foy player to the ground, drawing the foul.
I think you're seeing a little frustration from Pollard as she's not getting the space she wants.
As we see a foul underneath the basket. Clark and Letang tangled up. Letang hits the deck rather hard. Get a second look here. Letang on the ground. Tangles up with her legs into Clark. Foul called on Letang. She's going to check out of this one. Adam surveying the floor, finds Simovich. Gives back to Adams up top. Killer cross. Tries to pass into Pollard. Can't get it to her. Penetration by St. Foy. Nobody moving for VIU on defense. They're going to be called for the foul underneath. VIU looking rather lackadaisical.
Looked like good defense to me by Emily Clark, at least on the first block. They're really struggling with the Diamondbacks down low, Ryan.
Pollard's going to check out Victoria Brown in the 6'1 sophomore forward.
We've seen her score a nice basket from the painted area down low in the first half. They may look to her to provide some energy down on the block and box out and make sure they don't give up any more offensive rebounds.
Dominique Doré, 2 for 2 at the line. St. Foy bench likes that. They're up 5. Corner 3 is going to go off the side of the iron. Official's going to go up with the right hand. Foul underneath. Coach Rock doesn't like that one.
The Mariners came in to the third quarter 4 of 9 from the three-point line, now 4 of 11. So not finding much success there, but they are in this game, only down by 5, 2:42 left in the third quarter. Victoria Brown on the free throw line.
Brown's gonna hit her first. Two for two at the line is Brown.
4 points now for Victoria Brown. Lene Adams leads all scorers with 10.
Ball in the corner. 4 to shoot. Good if it goes, and it does. Shot from Olette Avenue. Downtown, the three.
Marchand with the triple, extending her point total to 10 and the lead to 6.
Yeah, you looking to get something doing here on the offensive end.
3 on the shot clock.
The step through floater won't go. Really a bad shot taken in late in the shot clock. Ball's gonna go baseline for St. Foy. Mid-range jumper, it's good.
And credit Marchand for her effort near the top of the perimeter. She was able to come up with the basketball, not give it up to Lene Adams, who was on her way for a steal. Great work by the Diamondiques.
And we see a replay as the Mariners take a timeout. Good penetration, got her space, and shot the elbow jumper. Finds nothing but nylon for 2. And St. Foy really starting to separate here late in the third quarter.
And we are seeing the St. Foy Diamondiques running a really efficient offense. We see them scoring from the three-point line, then getting inside and hitting off the elbow. We've seen them score in the paint several times. So really showing some versatility offensively, but then on the defensive end, not giving up any offensive rebounds to the Mariners, playing really good team basketball, great passing, and this is why they have an 8-point lead.
You're watching CCAA Women's Basketball National Championship action on we-tv.ca here. Live from the St. Clair College Sportsplex in lovely Windsor, Ontario. The last day of winter before the weather starts to heat up. But inside the gym, the basketball action's heating up. 40-32. St. Foy leads the VIU Mariners. Adams inbounds to Simovich. Needs to break this press. Active hands is gonna get the steal. Result for the easy 2-point layup for Rachel Marceau.
And now the St. Foy Diamondiques with their biggest lead of the game, 10 points.
That reverse layup won't go for Keir. Kicks to the corner. Didn't like the shot. Foul's gonna be called to St. Foy. Rachel Marceau get another look here. It's gonna be off ball. As Leanne Adams nearly came up with the steal there before the official went up with the right hand and the whistle. Simovich brings it up. Soft press. Ball goes inside to Brown. Tries to muscle her way to the basket. Won't go, however. St. Foy running the fast break. And 1. Count the basket. Fighting through some contact. That's Clue.
And that was all about effort, Ryan. The Diamondiques come up with the defensive rebound, breakout in transition, and Clue able to finish a tough shot at the rim, the 3-point play the old way.
Clue's free throw won't go. Simovich has her shot denied. Paint presence on defense is being heard. St. Foy not allowing anything inside here in the third quarter. 4 seconds left. Shot's good if it goes. It's gonna rattle around, no good. At the end of 3 quarters, Diamondiques on top, 44-32, 12-point game. Stick with us here. Fourth quarter coming up in the CCAA Women's Basketball National Championships here on we-tv.ca.
Manpower. That's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the $1 billion parkway. That's real manpower in action. End to end, over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LiUNA. Feel the power.
It's new, it's fresh, it's innovative, it's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, places, and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WeTV, we got you covered.
And we are back, CCAA Women's Basketball National Championship action here on we-tv live from the St. Clair College Sportsplex. The St. Foy Dominiques on top of the VIU Mariners 44-32. And Kobe, What does VIU need to do in this fourth quarter if they want to win this game?
Well, they're 7 of 26 from the field, so they got to be more efficient offensively. And then the rebounds, they're getting badly battered, 39-22. The Dominiques, 15 total team assists, really moving the ball well. The Mariners have to find some offense, and they need to do it desperately.
Aggressive offensive rebound by Brown. Official goes up with the right hand. So we get a second look at this. The long rebound here.
The Dominiques with 11 different players scoring so far in this game, Ryan. Really a testament to the depth that they're using. They're also outscoring the Mariners off the bench 12-4. So the concerted team effort really paying dividends, and we're seeing it on the scoreboard, 44-32, the 12-point lead in the fourth quarter. Make it 11 as Lene Adams hits the free throw.
As Lene Adams is going to come up with the steal after the Brown free throws. Ball goes to the wing for Simović. Showing her handles, but still has only has four to shoot. Forces up the corner three. It's gonna catch nothing but air.
That zone defense forcing the Mariners to take difficult shots.
Denied down low. Simović with a volleyball spike. It's gonna fall out of bounds. However, we're gonna get a second look at this. Simović not allowing anything in the paint. Bats that one away. Could have used their defense there. It's an easy lay-in for Clue. Can he put the St. Foy Dominiques up 13? Now their largest lead of the game. VIU going to need a big run to stay in this one. Brown's going to go up and do some window shopping. It's going to fall.
The Mariners desperately needed those 2 points from number 15, Victoria Brown, who comes through in the post.
That could have been the nail in the coffin, folks, as the long three won't go. Adams running the fast break, doesn't have numbers, but she does not care. Disregards her lack of help, tries to do it all herself, and she gets fouled. So we're gonna get a second look here. Adams going coast to coast. Goes up with the left hand.
looking to add to her point total. She has 10 so far in this one, the leading scorer for the Mariners and most definitely the best player on the floor for that team. She's really been a leader throughout this tournament. She looks to close the gap from the free throw line, and she makes the first.
Adams shooting her second of two, trying to shorten this lead to 9. She will.
The Mariners at around 80% from the line. They are finding success from the charity stripe.
That lofty pass will stay in bounds. St. Foy doing a great job moving the basketball all around. That three is going to be forked up. Won't go, though.
Diamond Eakes with all kinds of space to shoot, Ryan. The Mariners need to tighten things up defensively.
Yeah, you need to start chucking up some shots. They will. High arcing three. Steph Curry style.
Simovic with her second three-pointer of the contest. 7 points now for her.
We're trading three-point shots here, and that one's gonna go.
Marchant with 13 now, and all kinds of space to shoot.
Ball goes on the floor. So we're gonna get another look at this three by Marchand. Ball, good penetration. Elects to kick it out. Trading threes now are both teams. Neither team finding an abrupt amount of success. We see another three fired up. Simovic, that one won't go. As I was saying, neither team having a ton of success from three early on. Trading attempts now, and they're starting to fall. See a foul down low. Marchand trying to go to the hoop.
6:50 left in the fourth and final frame.
We're going to see who this one was on. Looks like Lane Adams tried to go straight up with the hands. Officials weren't buying it. The 5'10 sophomore guard from Vancouver. Ten-point lead now for the time being. It'll stay that way. Pollard with the rebound. VIU trying to run the fast break offense. Too strong off the glass. A miss opportunity with 6.5 to go. That three's gonna fall short for Chabot.
And completely undefended on the perimeter. All kinds of time to shoot.
While looking to extend their 10-point lead, the step through is going to fall. It'll go for two.
And that
and
was
a VIU timeout will be taken. We're going to get a second look here at the step through. Executing their offense to perfection is St. Foy. Penetration going left side. May have been a missed travel call there. Nonetheless, the basket will be good for the 2 points as we get a look at the fouls and timeouts left for both teams.
The Diamond Eakes with a 12-point lead, Ryan, but still time left. We know basketball is a game of runs, and it is time for the Mariners to do a gut check, dig deep, and see what they can do, you know, in the final 5 minutes or so that are remaining in this game.
Looks like this one could come down to the wire should VIU get back into it, go on a quick run here as this timeout is gonna wind down.
This is your bronze medal qualifier. One of these teams will go on. It's been a dogfight, that is for sure, my friend. Still 6:16 remaining in the fourth and final quarter, Ryan. So sometime.
Adams will be on the baseline to inbound. She gets a double team. Good press defense here, but an even better press break from VIU. Simovic tosses back up top. Adams on the wing, now drives. Mid-range jumper will fall. She's singing the nylon song tonight for 2 points. Shortens it to a 10-point lead now.
14 on the game for number 7, Lene Adams.
And a turnover, double dribble is called.
And here's an opportunity for the Mariners. They score a bucket, they get one back off a turnover to now cut it to single digits on this possession.
VIU wants to get it down low to Pollard. They're gonna try to. Ball's gonna be coughed up. Who's gonna come up with it? Looks like St. Flaw off that magic square back there and in. That's Rachel Marcot.
No shortage of effort there on either team.
Marcot's gonna kiss it off glass on the fast break. All alone there for the easy 2 points. And another miss opportunity for VIU. If they're gonna wanna get back into this game, they're gonna need to execute on every possession.
Yep, down 12 with 5 and change remaining.
Simovic shot won't fall. VIU going to need a stop here before this game gets out of hand. Six to shoot. It's gonna fall. More points in the paint for St. Foy. 56-52, the 14-point lead, now the largest of the game. The off-ball foul called on Nada Tefe. We get a second look. What was going on down low here? The girls get set. Ball goes into Pollard. She drives left hand. It's gonna spin all the way around the rim.
And a basket the Mariners desperately needed from one of their big three.
4:20 left to play in this one. St. Foy trying to be smart with the basketball, not giving VIU any opportunities. VIU closing down their passing lanes well. Deep three, no good. Tipped around and the Diamondiques gonna keep it here. The off the long offensive board. Mid-range jumper, front iron won't go.
Clark
with it on the wing. Adams now, deep two, it'll go.
16 points now for Adams, who is desperately trying to get the Mariners back in this thing.
Lucky break there, Pollard had a 2-on-1. Just over 3 to play, 4 to shoot. That one's turned over anyway. Clark comes up with it. Now the ball's tipped away.
That was a big misplay for the Mariners, who just tossed away the turnover.
Winter might be ending, but both teams coughing up the ball here.
But the Mariners do come back up with the basketball.
Nice crossover from Marcoux.
You see the Mariners talking it over at center court, communicating as Pollard gets set to make these, to shoot these oh so important free throws.
She's gonna miss her first. A rough day all around for Pollard. Couldn't get anything going inside.
2:47 remains in this one, and the Dominiques with a 9-point advantage, Ryan.
Coming up after this one, the St. Mary's Lightning are gonna take on the St. Clair Saints in the consolation round.
So the Dominiques turning the ball over at a crucial time, and here the Mariners have another opportunity to chop into this lead.
Mariners going to need to capitalize on this possession if they want to stay in it. 2:20 left. Left-hand floater, it's good.
McFarland coming up with a huge basket for the Mariners.
And we're going to get a second look here at the last basket for the Mariners. Penetration going left hand. Killer cross. So Watt thought she was getting screened. An easy bucket off the glass for two there. VIU gonna need a stop if they wanna stay in it. The step through, it's no good.
Huge board for the Mariners.
McFarland hits the deck, she gets back to play some offense. They'll find her on the wing. Minute and a half left to go. That three ball and things are getting interesting. 56-52. That triple's gonna keep VIU in the game. And take a look at this. Good penetration, kick out, hand in her face, nothing but net.
Simovich now with three triples, and that one couldn't have come at a better time.
Simovich dropping more trays than a nervous cafeteria lady here in this one. As that ball's tipped out, St. Foy's gonna keep it.
And you see the sense of urgency that the Mariners are playing with now.
Mariners showing some effort here in the late going. Could it be too little, too late? Only down four. Coach Bill McWinnie looks on, hoping his team could use this press to get some stops, get into the game. Ball nearly turned over. Flurry of players hitting the deck. Seven to shoot. And another foul on Jamie McFarland.
That will be her fourth. She stays in the game. 1:15 left in the fourth. Mariners down by four.
Important stop here for VIU. Almost coming up with a steal there. That's gonna be a shot clock violation, so a crucial turnover here late in the game. This one's gonna come down to the wire. Exactly 60 seconds left to play. And Lane Adams inbounds.
Credit the Mariners defense there, Ryan, for a job well done.
Bucket here would make it a one possession game. They're gonna try and get it, but within one. Simovich three won't go. And now the fouling begins. Emily Clark with the intentional foul there.
So the Diamondbacks. Will inbound the basketball.
.3 seconds left to go in this one. Tightly contested game for most of the fourth quarter. Ball's tipped out of bounds by Clark. 23-2 shoot. Almost a full shot clock here. And another quick foul, this time by Simovich.
This is going to put Marchand on the line. The Diamondbacks shooting over 50% collectively from the free throw line, but haven't been too strong from the charity stripe in this one, Ryan. But these are such important and crucial free throws down the stretch, and Marchand looks to add to her 14-point total.
She will make her first 15th points of the night. That one's good as well. Rachel Marco checks back into this contest. We have a timeout on the floor. Just under a minute left to go. And Colby, we definitely didn't think it would be this tight of a game coming into the fourth quarter, but here late, the IUs really give the Diamondbacks a run for their money.
Yeah, it's certainly a concerted team effort by the Mariners down the stretch. It could be a little bit too late, but there's still some time left. They're down by six. Regardless, a great effort in the fourth quarter, and this Diamondbacks team has done a fantastic job through the course of four quarters and really shown the kind of consistency needed to win basketball games like this.
And after this one is over, stay tuned here on we-tv.ca for the Windsor Honda postgame report. Dom Popple will give you all the action and the recaps from here at the St. Clair Sportsplex. More games coming up here on we-tv.ca all day from the CCAA Women's Basketball National Championships. St. Clair and St. Mary's, 2 o'clock consolation game.
We could see a quick three here, three-point attempt by the Mariners. Just 36.6 left in this one.
Going to need to get this one to go, and Adams will.
It will be a long two-point, though, but still closing the gap. Who other than Lene Adams coming up big, 18 points.
Brings this one down to a 58-52 game. Timeout on the floor, I believe taken by the Diamondbacks. Both teams talking it over, getting their late game defense. So we have a score correction now, 58-54 is the score. So still a two possession game.
And now the chess match begins. You know, where do you foul? You know, when the Mariners get positioned, do they make the 3-point attempt or do they try to score a quick basket down low? Not much time left, but certainly not over, Ryan.
Coach Bill McWinnie of the VIU Mariners discussing that with his team, talking about who to foul, when to foul, and what they want to do if those foul shots don't fall. Just 33 seconds left in this contest. 4-point game.
Diamondbacks going with a little bit smaller of a lineup than what we've seen.
St. Foy has led it by as many as 14 in this contest. Now the lead down to only four. So foul is called.
Sirios comes into the game, number 24. She's had two blocks. She's played great defense for the Diamondiques.
Mayhem LeClerc. She'll hit her first. Some clutch free throw shooting here by LeClerc. She's gonna need this one to go. It will.
Big time buckets there by LeClerc, who makes both at such a crucial point. 31 seconds left.
6-point game here. VIU gonna need a three. They'll elect to drive all the way to the hoop. And another quick foul. This one could be out of reach here. Two possession game. We're gonna have some free throws coming up on the other end. At the line for two, Rachel Marco. Coach Bill McWinney calls off some of his starters. All smiles from the VIU bench, but they know this one has just been put out of reach. A couple of free throws here. Looks like St. Foy will advance to take on the Ooks. Three from the corner. Shot won't go. An unfortunate turn of events and what turned out to be an exciting finish.
And Emily Clark made that shot, but she had stepped out of bounds.
There's a reason they put those lines there. St. Foy needs to get it into the front court. They'll just let the clock run out on this one. And a final here. 61-54 is your final from the St. Clair Sportsplex. St. Foy defeats the VIU Mariners. Colby, who is the player of the game here today?
I believe Lene Adams will be your player of the game for the VIA Mariners. And then for your Diamondiques, possibly LeClerc. Made some key baskets, free throws at the end of the game. We will have to see. But a real team effort by the Diamondiques. They came in here and were more consistent through the course of four quarters. They did a great job on the glass, in the paint, and they rotated the ball well.
Now, the winner of this game, as I alluded to earlier, will take on the Ooks. That game is tonight at 6 o'clock. That's the CCAA bronze medal game here on WE-TV. The Nate Ooks from Alberta taking on these Diamondiques de St. Foy. That can be seen here exclusively on WE-TV. A total team effort here from both teams. And this game here between the Ooks and the Diamondiques, I know, Colby, you were not on the call for the Ooks game. I, however, was. I'm sure you heard about the game. We see the players of the game for both teams. Miriam LeClerc receiving her drawstring bag, courtesy of Adidas.
She did a great job down the stretch, Ryan. Played a great game altogether, but certainly in the fourth quarter. And then what more can you say about Lene Adams? 18 collective points. She did a good job on the glass, passed the ball well. Maybe the best player on the floor tonight for both teams.
Lene Adams couldn't get her team the victory. Nonetheless, a great game. And as I was alluding to earlier, that this Ooks Diamondiques matchup will be one fans will want to watch here later today on WE-TV. And we will take a quick commercial break. Stay tuned, though, for the Windsor Honda post-game press conference with Dominic Papa coming up after this commercial break.
We'll be right back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Manpower. That's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the billion-dollar parkway. That's real manpower in action. End-to-end over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well-trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LiUNA. Feel the power.
It's new. It's fresh. It's innovative. It's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, places, and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WeTV, we got you covered.
And he knows I got him beat over here with this one.
I got blindsided. Look at that.
That's nothing. Look at this. Look at this. Half moon.
Here we go.
How many stables did you get?
45.
45?
Oh.
Never would have thought that.
We'll see you soon.
Thanks.
Manpower. That's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the billion-dollar parkway. That's real manpower in action. End-to-end over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well-trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LiUNA. Feel the power.
Welcome back to the St. Clair College Sportsplex, the site of the 2016 CCAA Women's National Basketball Championships. This is the Windsor Honda post-game press conference. We'll also announce the Windsor Honda players of the game. We're going to start first with the winning team here of this bronze medal semifinal game. The Dynamique de Saint-Foix win 61-54 over Vancouver Island University Mariners. Joining us, we're pleased to have and honored to have Coach Dave LaRoche. Joining him is the Windsor Honda player of the game for the team, Miriam Leclerc. Coach LaRoche, congratulations on the victory. How important was it for you to get your team to the bronze medal game?
We talk about it all year long. We want to get a chance to play for a medal here. We lost in the semifinal yesterday, but I think we regrouped very well for this morning. We play hard and won our goal. It's now in our bag. We're still playing for a medal, so that's good for us.
How tough was this game this morning, Coach? I'm sure you've had many tough games throughout the season. Just to get there is a tough ride. But to come back on such short time, prepare your team for a very good opponent in Vancouver Island, how tough was this game for your team to put together?
It was very tough. I think the girls did a pretty good job. They went to breakfast together this morning. They have a lot of smile, listen to music, have fun. And then we fight hard for 40 minutes. And then I think that in the second half, we start really we made our momentum and start shooting well the ball. So it's been a 20 tough first minute, and then I think that we came back as our club in the second half.
Yeah, you opened it up a little bit. Let's get Miriam in here. Miriam Leclerc, the player of the game. Congratulations to you, Miriam, on that. How good does this feel for you and your teammates to know that you have a shot at taking home a medal now? Miriam, how different has the basketball been here in the first three games here for you? Do you sense a different play than what you're normally accustomed to when you play in your league?
Mais je pense qu'ici, ils sont beaucoup plus physiques. They are really physical. And they are faster, and we need to be more physical and both strong.
I love your English, but your French is fine too. If you want to say it in French, if we're okay with that. So how excited are you to go to the bronze medal game now? And how much energy do you think you have left?
I think we have a lot of energy. We need to change.
Save it.
Save it, and we need to just do everything that we can do.
Okay, say it in French now.
Hein?
En français now.
Je pense qu'on doit vraiment garder cette énergie, laisser aller la prochaine game pour que vraiment on donne tout ce qui nous reste pour avoir une médaille.
Coach, another tough challenge for you and Coach Jonas Bjerre, your assistant. Short period of time, you got to come back and play another tough game. The Nate Ooks, who've had a great tournament. You know the team well. What's going to be key for your club when you get into that game?
We have to get good composure on defense. They got a really good big man. She scores like 30 points this morning. She's very good. And I think that we have to be better at passing the ball to this morning. It was tough that the ball was stay too much longer in the hands of our guard. I think that we got to pass the ball very, very, very good, and we have to shoot well too. So I think that we have to play like we played 2 weeks ago in our league when we got in the finals.
Okay.
If we play like that, I think we're going to be good.
Okay, good stuff. Congratulations to both of you. Good luck in the bronze medal game, okay, Coach?
Thanks
for your time. That's this first half of the Windsor Honda press conference. When we come back after the break, we'll talk to the Vancouver Island University squad, Bill McWinney, and their player of the game, Lene Adams, will join us. You're watching the 2016 CCAA Women's National Basketball Championships on WE TV.
Manpower. That's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the $1 billion parkway. That's real manpower in action. End to end, over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LIUNA. Feel the power.
Continuing on with our Windsor Honda post-game press conference here at the CCAA Women's National Basketball Championships. The opponent in the bronze medal game, the semifinal bronze medal game, has been decided. The Dynamiques de Sainte-Foy win over Vancouver Island University Mariners 61-54. We now check in with the Vancouver Island University Mariners. We're very pleased and honored to have head coach Bill McWinney with us, and also the Windsor Honda player of the game for the team, Lene Adams, joins us. Congratulations to both of you, first of all, on getting this far in the tournament. I'm sure there's disappointment right now, but coach, where did you see the difference in the game today that was able to give Sainte-Foy the victory?
I think the big thing for them was offensive rebounds. I think, you know, they did a good job on their first shots, you know, contested and challenged, but they're getting two to three chances every time down the floor. You don't have to shoot a good percentage in order to score. I think the difference was the offensive rebounds.
Preparing for this game, coach, how tough was that with such a short turnaround, and
I mean, obviously you've been watching the tournament and you've got, you know, a good bird's eye view of what you're playing against, but just the same, it's not only the game plan preparation, but the physicality, the mental preparation. How tough was that?
I think it was easier for us than them. Mm-hmm. They did play last night and lost the semifinal game, so I thought the situation was okay for us, coming off the win versus them after a loss. It was a late night preparing for them, but you know, the girls got back, we got their feet up and rest, and there's no excuses there. We played our cans off today.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's get Lene into this. Lene, congratulations on being named player of the game for your team. Just your thoughts about the, you know, the season coming to an end like this, and how tough that will be.
I mean, it's always tough to lose, mm-hmm, sure. But at the same time, we played as a team, and it's been a good season as a team. So, like, just the experience. This is my first year ever being at Nationals, so, like, I think it was just a good experience altogether, just mm-hmm. being here with my team. It was unfortunate we lost, but it was a great game, so I enjoyed it.
Being that it was your first Nationals, Lene, how much do you think you'll be able to absorb and take into next year and continue leading this team?
I think I'm able to absorb all of it. Mm-hmm. Every game is a new competition, so being able to see teams from other provinces mm-hmm. and other conferences kind of gives me an idea of how to compare and how to prepare for next year.
All right, Coach McWinney, the state of the team and your evaluation on the year for your club.
Oh, we had a great year.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, you win the PacWest regular season, you win the conference tournament, you come to Nationals, you finish fifth in the country. I'm super proud of my kids. Mm-hmm. You know, we lose the heart and soul of our team in Jamie McFarland, but everybody else is able to come back. You know, we'll add a couple of pieces, and you know, we're ready to roll next year. I'm nothing but proud of my kids. They played hard all season long, did everything that's asked of them.
Well said, Coach, and I agree with you. From what we saw of this team, outstanding. So congratulations again, and hopefully you get back to where you want to be next year, and congratulations just on a great tournament, though, okay?
Thank you. We'll be back.
All right. That's this edition of the Windsor Honda post-game press conference. Stick around in about 10 or 15 minutes. We're going to be back with the 7th, 8th place game. That'll feature the St. Mary's Lightning taking on the host team, the St. Clair College Saints. On behalf of everybody here at WE TV, this is Dominic Papa wishing you a great day. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. We'll see you again soon.
Tom is trying to justify buying a new car. That should do it.
Need a good reason? There's never been a better time to get yourself into the best-selling car in Canada for 17 years. Now, during the Honda Model Clearout, get a $1,000 Civic bonus when you finance any new 2015 Civic model.